Today we will see how you can use Signal with Observable inside one application and use the power of RxJS and power of Signal combined in your application. So let's start the video. Hi everyone, this is Subrat and you are watching Fun of Heuristics. So on this channel, we'll make videos like this, which is related to programming and web development. So please consider subscribing and hit the bell icon if you haven't yet. On our last video, we have discussed about what is Signal and how you can use Signal in your application, and we have developed a to-do application there. And if you haven't watched that video, please go ahead and watch that one. I will link them in the card. And in this video, we'll discuss about how you can use Observable and Signal together to have a fuller application. So here, as you can see, we have a application with just a to-do application, and this application we have developed in our previous video. So here you can add something, search that task if you have any, or you can delete something. Okay, so this is the basic functionality and we have used Signal to achieve that. So today we'll try to make this application and try to plug that with a backend call. We'll simulate backend call. I will not going to make actual backend call here. I have created a data service here. If you go here, it's just a mimic of a backend call. So here, what we need to do first, we need to inject the data service. And to change our signal to an observable, we have a method called toSignal, and which we can use either while instantiating a variable like this, or you can use it inside a constructor. So first, we'll make a call to the server to have all the tasks. So for that, we'll do this. So here we are using toSignal, which is you will convert your observable to signal. That's why the name is toSignal. And in that, we are passing our get task. If you go inside get task, it is just returning an observable of a string array. So here the strings are our tasks. But think like this is mimicking, you are calling a backend, getting the data as a list of string, or any format that matters. And if you remember in a past video, we saw that while instantiating a signal, you need a default value. Suppose you are instantiating a string, signal of type string. So you need to pass either empty string or some default value. Signal must contain some value. So here we are saying that our initial value is empty array. And one thing to note here, and that's the benefit as well, when you do this, Signal takes care of subscribing to this observable, and destroying that means here whenever our component will be destroyed, Signal will also going to be destroyed, and in turn observable will also going to be unsubscribed. You can think this like as a async pipe, but you can use it everywhere. We are saying that we got our user task and we are setting our old task array with the user task. Now if you just save, and we will go to our application, and here you can see we are getting the data from the service, and that is populated here, and everything else will going to work because we haven't done anything apart from like calling the server, converting the observable to signal and assigning that value to our signal here. Now we'll see the addition scenario, how we're going to add task by calling our backend. So for that, the approach I have selected to create an observable here, I have just created an add subject. So here I will just comment this, and inside this I will just use this dot add subject dot next and just emit some empty string here. I will use this add subject inside our constructor, and for that we can do this. So what I'm doing here, I'm using the add subject, piping that with switch map, calling our service add task. Whichever data you are returning from that, I'm just using a tap operator. You can use map or tap according to your scenario, and just updating our tasks signal here and assigning this signal to another variable just to use it in future. And now we'll go and see how this works. Go to our task and I'll just try to do something, hit add, and you'll see after 2 seconds, it will be added. And I have did a mistake here because I'm emitting an empty string here instead of the input value which we have entered there. So I'll just go ahead and update this. Now if we'll go to our application, and here we'll see whenever it types something, it will take 2 seconds to add and it will be added. And why it's taking 2 seconds? Because we have added a delay in our add task. So this is what the power of toSignal with observable. Now you can pipe multiple operator. Like suppose I want to add a loader. So I will just create a loader variable and I will go here, tap operator, and just set the loader to true. Now whenever our subject will trigger, it will set loader to true. So one thing you can do here, you can use another tap operator just to make this false. But here we're going to use effects. And that you can do like this. And what is an effect? Effect is similarly like computed here. So if there is any change or any trigger with the signal, the computed will going to execute. Similarly, if there is any trigger in the signal using inside effect, the effect will going to execute. So if I save, so here what we are doing after this signal will execute, we'll set our loader to false. And in our HTML, we'll just add this. So when the loader is true, a adding text will be visible. So now if we'll go to our application here and if we'll try to add something, we are able to see the loading screen or loading text and the thing is getting added. And to delete a task, we have added a delete subject similar to our add subject, and we'll use this delete subject inside our delete function. So instead of this, we'll use this. So we are using our delete subject and passing the index as a next value, and I will just comment this. We'll use this delete subject inside our constructor as well. So here, similar to our add task, what we're doing, we are using toSignal, and here one point you can notice that I'm just using toSignal here so that it will subscribe to this, and it will also going to unsubscribe to the delete subject or to add subject whenever our component is destroyed. So what I'm doing here in our delete subject is we're piping it with our switch map and a tap operator. Here we are using switch map and calling our delete task, but here you can also use concat map, because switch map is not a good scenario here. And if you want to know where to use concat map, where to use switch map, I have a video. I will link them in the card so you will be more clear to that. So here we are using concat map because you can delete multiple item before you get a response back from the server. We are using concat map and we are calling our delete task from our data service. And whichever index we are getting back from our data service, we are going and we are updating our task signal similar to which we have done here. And we'll go to our application and here you will see, I will try to delete something. It is deleted. I'll try to add. We're adding it. And now we'll see how we can use toObservable method. To use that, suppose in this scenario, what we can do, if you have an autocomplete service, so whenever you are typing, you want to give some delay timeout. And that is very easy in the case of observable, where we have debounce time operator, we can pipe that with our input field and we are done. What we can do here, we already have our task string signal. So I will just use a temp variable here. So it just temp observable, and I will say equals to toObservable, and I will pass our signal. So this is will be this dot task string. And now our temp observable is an observable of our task string signal. What you can do, you can directly pipe it here, or you can use the variable to pipe. So I will just pipe our debounce timeout, debounce time, and I will give some time as a 300 millisecond. And then you can use your switch map, exhaust map, concat map, or any map that matters. So, and you can use a switch map and you can pass the data to your server, or call your server, get the response back and update whatever you want. So that's it, guys. Today we saw how you can use toSignal or toObservable method to combinedly use with our existing signal so that our application will be fuller. And fuller means now you can call your server, and as our HTTP calls are observable, so you get an observable back and pipe that with various operator which RxJS provide and use the power of RxJS and power of signal combined in your application. So please hit the like button if you like the video till now. Please do subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified for the future videos. Please do share this video among your friends, family, colleagues. We're going to meet in the next video. Till then, stay happy. Bye-bye.